Hello and welcome back. My name is Hollow Empathy and this is Final Fantasy 15. So last episode we met the Marshal Cor Leonis and he provided us a tomb. Oh no, he didn't provide us a tomb, he provided us a key to the Royal Tombs, which opened up I guess what is going to be the main plot of this game, or the main objective in this game, which is going and finding all of the various tombs, of which there are 13 in total, and collecting the royal arms, two of which we have already collected, and hopefully continuing the story will give us a lead or a clue as to where to find the next one. But if we also just happen across another tomb in the meantime...
Want to take a break? I'm fine. Come on! Break time! Break time!
We can just open it straight away and go straight in. For now, though, got to talk to Monica, so let's see what she has to say.
Your Highness, the Marshal has apprised me of the plan. We've found a back door into the Imperial base. I'll mark the route on your map. The way is secure. You should be able to gain entry relatively easily.
Okay, so I guess just like that, the new goal is to head to the border. First, because it is night, I'm gonna go have a rest. And hopefully we won't be accosted by any unexpected tours.
Made it.
But if we are, that would be okay too. Oh, serious practice. Okay, let's see what that is first then. The first training exercise I did on my own, the basic drills, it is just like a fight with Gladio, same as in the tutorial. The first time you complete it, you get AP. So I assume first time we complete serious practice, we'll also get AP. Okay, straight into combat. Straight into wait mode. Weak to machinery and thunder. Okay. Well, I do have machinery. Do I have thunder? I do have thunder. Okay. Equip that. And machinery, auto crossbow. Why do I always say that wrong?
Let's move.
Yeah.
Try this on your side.
What is this? How? Okay. Holding down square obviously isn't how you attack with the crossbow. This is rubbish, this is not going well at all. I think you have to hold it to aim and then release to fire. But who really knows, and it just leaves me a second sitting duck for Gladio to whack me with his greatsword. And he is kicking my ass. That did not go very well.
Not looking so good, Prince Charmless.
Nice one. Call me that from now on.
There's really no point trying to use new weapons in this game. It's better just sticking with what you know. What? What? You just needed one blast. One freaking blast of Thunderer, and that was it. That's all it took. As opposed to struggling with this really unwieldy weapon that he is supposedly weak to. Why is everything in this game annoying? And of course that's an exaggeration. But the game just seems to have these really weird quirks that just trip you up for no real reason. I will not be using machinery again. It is way too difficult to control in a game that is already unnecessarily difficult to control. So let's go to sleep.
It could crash right here.
You can remain awake long enough to eat.
The training is also annoying because it gives Noctis XP, which means that he gets more XP than the other party members. And in my case, Iggy is already further behind on XP than the others because he did actually die at one point. What's something that I have lots of ingredients for? Hmm. There's nothing which is incredibly abundant, at least not in every ingredient that it needs. So let's go for Gladio's. Maybe we'll actually... like Gladio's favorite meal. Maybe we'll actually make use of the XP bonus this time, because we didn't last time. Not XP bonus, but bonus to his techniques and leveling up his techniques faster. So I should remember to actually use Tempest. Yeah, as you can see, Iggy is further behind than the others because he did already die, but if that hadn't have been the case, then everyone would have the same amount of XP. Everyone would be leveling evenly, and then Noctis gets just a bit more XP for the training, and it's enough to just make them not even anymore, and that can be annoying for completionists. So that's not really a completionist thing, but an OCD thing. People who
if
like things
Cindy.
To all be evenly spread and just so.
Not bad.
Prompto selfie.
Hey, this one's pretty good.
I know. I dig it too.
This is me running back to the spot where I left the last episode so I could start this episode in the same place. That's kind of silly. Any tours cropping up? Oh, maybe. When Noctis is frenzied, their favorite foods at camp, their techniques may develop faster or deliver critical hits more often. Well, why is he telling me that now? Because it's not like it's the first time I've eaten his favorite food or anything. Let's get back to the car and see where we need to go. Quest location. That's really not very far away. No, I won't
Everything
do the fast travel when it's this close by, because the loading screen is probably going to take longer than the driving. At least like this we can look at things, look at the scenery. We're a third of the way in already.
Who is this Monica person?
A servant of the Crown's Guard, like Gladio and myself.
She's one of my father's best, along with Dustin, who's guarding my sister.
Good to know we still have people we can count on outside the city.
Should be a nice change of pace.
That was better than a loading screen. Right, which way is this quest marker? What's the point of even having all of these fences around? They don't seem to be sealing anything off. Use his technique.
Want some?
And now I can.
Can try this.
Why he couldn't before, though, I don't know.
Come, Tom. How about this?
This casually kicks me out of the way.
Getting by. Ignis, if I may.
That's why in real life it's a bad idea to stand behind animals, but in video games, and this one in particular, it gives you critical hits.
Any problems?
Don't worry about me.
Gladio, do it!
Inside.
Sorry!
No use hanging around here.
So I wonder what side this is on, whether I should be going right or left. Or if it doesn't matter. There's a stamina bar when I run now because I turned it on when I was trying to beat Gladio in the race. And it was useful to see like when I could and couldn't sprint. And I have just haven't turned it off again since. I might turn it off again a bit later on because it is a bit of an eyesore and just kind of gets in the way of what is otherwise just a very nice, very scenic environment. But at the same time, it is quite useful knowing when I can and can't sprint. Oh, hello. It's a convenient crevice.
From here, we will split into two groups. Prince Noctis, please join the Marshal up ahead. The rest of you will assist me in the diversionary effort.
I wonder why he didn't vocalize that.
I'll see you guys later.
You go give him hell.
When has it ever been a good idea to split up? I mean, any piece of media. When has it ever been a good idea that people split up? You can actually come to this narrow gap in the wall at any point in the game. It just won't let you go through it until you have this quest. Noctis just seems to deny himself the ability to do these
Once
things
we're in,
until he has permission.
We launch our ambush, pushing out while support pushes in, crushing the enemy from both sides.
Shiny! Ignore core, get high potion. Okay. Wasn't expecting there to be enemies quite so soon. Quite so suddenly. I was pressing L1 to target.
Pathetic. Whoops. Never mind. Focus on the battle.
Yeah. It's a little easier with Cor around.
Don't get used to it. I'll be gone before you know it.
I'll enjoy it while I can.
Always. Every time.
Above us.
Got it.
Yeah, there's really not much point being a sniper when you're up against Prince Noctis.
Too slow.
Cor killed the others already.
Will the others be alright on their own?
Worry, no. We'll only compromise your focus.
Yeah, yeah.
I
pathetic. It's over.
No. Don't phase right off the edge again.
Walk through the park.
So it should be. Otherwise, you'd only get in everyone's way.
Could have gone it alone if I wanted.
That mentality could prove your undoing, Highness.
I don't quite know of any other video game where I keep jumping instead of opening doors. It just doesn't happen.
Knocked!
Marshal, it's good to see you again.
No one's
all
dead.
Right, on your end. Ray.
Right as rain. The Nifs couldn't take their eyes off us.
Thanks to you, we were spared their attention.
Stay right where you are. Well, well, if it isn't Cor the Immortal. So, you survived the Citadel. But you won't survive what I have in store for you. It's past time your legend came to an end.
Is this the first de facto boss fight? If so, then I am digging it. And swapping gear over. Danger. And Gladio is not far behind. What, is he unable to use it? Oh no, he is. Okay. What does that mean? No, it doesn't mean he can't be Libra'd. That's fine, you're probably gonna be weak to lightning anyway. Like, giant mechs are always weak to lightning. I know this from FF7 and also Type Zero. Oh, you should also use. Oh, I can use Cor's techniques while he's a party member. But Gladio is the one with the boost. You're gonna be seeing a lot of Tempest. That's why I have recruit.
We must regroup.
No more fun and games.
Let's swap back to the greatsword again. Oh.
Don't let your guard down.
What? Did I do something? I was not ready for that. Unfortunately, I'm hurting my party members just as much as I'm hurting the enemy.
You got my back.
Hey, Ignis! Everyone regroup!
Okay.
Excuse me?
Give me.
You will suffer for this! I cannot be defeated! No! This can't be happening! In the name of Nevermind! No! No! Glory! Yeah. To the Empire!
Jeez! I'm getting some serious Type 0 vibes from this. I'll explain more later.
Impressive.
Did this cutscene?
Seeing you in action puts my mind at ease. It's clear I don't need to worry anymore. I'll return to watching the NIFs. Till next time, take care.
I've got that much XP again already? Jeez. Just got a trophy. No turning back.
Ain't so bad out here once you get used to it.
Still a lot we haven't seen, though.
And a lot for us to do.
Yeah.
Buck up. We're just getting started.
End of chapter already? That was a short chapter. And I guess chapter 1 would have been a short chapter 2 if I had just focused on the story and not done all the side quests, but even so. Evil enough. Noctis being confused by how doors work. Well, that's a pretty cool one actually. Save that just for the effects. And good to go. So I guess that means we're on chapter 3 now. That all happened very quickly. Chapter 3, The Open World. The Empire is a powerful foe, and Noctis has far to travel before he can hope to reclaim the crystal. He sets out across new lands in search of the power of his forebears. Is that the goal then, reclaiming the crystal? Because the trailers all said, reclaim your throne, not reclaim the crystal. I suppose it's a logical step he would need to take. But it's about operationalizing, and the next thing that we're doing, surely, is focusing on finding the arms. Finding the arms to get the crystal to reclaim the throne. I don't want to say too much because as soon as loading finishes loading, there's going to be another cutscene. So I don't really want to get into the middle of saying something, but I don't want to just not say anything. Because it's quite boring just waiting for these loading screens otherwise. So I'm just rambling, just to fill the time. Almost there.
So, the prince eludes death. And what of the elusive ring?
Eluna Freya has absconded with it.
Find and kill her. the ring is the final piece.
We may do well to take her alive. The six wield power beyond our imagination. The Oracle holds the key for the King. She could unlock many secrets. Nay, High Commander. Lord Ravis, the Imperial Army is now at your disposal.
A moot point, while the fugitives remain at large. My men and I will continue our search for the Prince and the Oracle.
So glorious. My crystal.
Ravis? Ravis? I thought he was dead.
Look out, world. Here we come.
We can finally leave this dust bowl behind.
The lands beyond are vast by comparison to lead.
Bigger's better. More stuff to see and do.
First comes to Sky, a region known for its wetlands.
Really? Wetlands?
There's also a chocobo forest.
Now we're
chocobos!
Talking.
Further west lies the Klain region, wherein we'll find the town of Lestalum.
Oh. Isn't that where Iris is headed?
Barring delays, she should have arrived by now. Maybe even had herself a look at the meteor.
The meteor of the Six?
The same. Its heat is harnessed to power Lestalum.
Whoa! That sounds way cool!
I'm actually looking forward to this.
It'll be a long drive. Best fill up the tank before we set out.
You mean before I turn back to Lida? Because I wasn't ready to leave.
The driver's seat is yours, Noct. If you so desire it.
What? Yes, finally! Why wasn't that just available from the start? Considering that it could be available from the start if I had actually selected the right option. Why arbitrarily lock me out of it until this point? Crazy. Yes, I've already done the tutorials, thank you. I've done them twice, in fact. Okay, so now let's see whereabouts we are, because we are in a new region. And apparently this is all part of the sky. It's going to be interesting to see what it looks like. But another time, because I didn't actually mean to progress to a new area. Like, there's still Dino's side quest to do all the way down in Golden Key. But all of the blockades are gone. So it's not just one base that we stormed, and one blockade that we forced our way through. They're now all gone. I guess that makes things easier to just be able to cross in various places. That was the wrong button. Of course it was. Wait, what? Dino's quest is gone! Dino's quest is gone. Oh wait, no, it's not. It's there. Okay, I was panicking then because I was expecting it to be orange. Just because in the past, the quests for Dino have been orange because it's been part of furthering the main story. That's not the case anymore, but I was so worried that I always would have to reload. I guess I might as well do the emergency delivery because it's so close. And then head back to Lida with the Gorilla Sirloin. After this... Also, it's raining.
Could this be?
Phone call first.
Hello?
Noct?
Iris?
It's really you! So good to hear your voice. Everything's fine over here. We managed to make it to Lestalum. We just settled into our new digs. So yeah, let me know when you're coming so we can meet up.
Yeah, will do.
You better.
Was that Iris? Can't even call her own brother.
In all fairness, yours wasn't the obituary broadcast all over Lucis.
What about me? She say anything about me? You see that sign? Chocobos! Chocobos!
No time for that. Need to get to Lastalum.
There's always time for chocobos.
Come on, just a quick visit!
Chocobo post.
Sure. Let's check it out.
Yes! Gonna be awesome!
It seems the game really wanted me to go to Lastalum, so I hope choosing to go to the Chocobo port instead will stall it so I don't have to go to Lastalum straight away. So side quest for Dave, side quest for Sonia, whoever Sonia is. Okay. Yeah, I guess picking up the new side quest. Oh, Nock can't jump on cars, that's weird. According to the car's hitbox, it all thinks it has the height of the roof. It doesn't realize that the front of the car is actually lower than the roof. It's just an invisible rectangle and it's not letting me jump on. Not that it matters, it's just
Let's
funny.
See.
Ignis! Shake a leg!
On my way.
Oh yeah, I was gonna say, because it's raining, I'm gonna change the outfits. And changing the outfits doesn't seem to actually have the effect that I thought it would. I'm really disappointed about that. It is mostly aesthetic. And stats do change, but it seems that those stats are fixed according to the outfit and not according to the type of day or the type of weather. And like, this is what I thought originally. I thought that each stat would just have a different emphasis. Like the Princess Fatigues have an emphasis on HP. Not having the jacket has an emphasis on the base stats. Like, what is it that decreases? So this would have higher strength and higher magic, but lower HP. Now this is designed to defend against stat reducing status ailments, and this allows the wearer to move freely and land critical hits more easily. So it doesn't depend on the environment or the scenario in the game. And when the characters talk, as though it does, it is just this wink and a nod from the developers, like, ah, our characters acknowledge what you're wearing and they do know whether you're wearing a jacket or not wearing the jacket. Ha ha, it's all very funny, like, wink wink, nod nod. But it's kind of disappointing now that it doesn't actually affect anything. Now they created that illusion that it did affect something and then you just realize, like, oh no, it doesn't. But I've been running around without a jacket for quite a long time. And it just like suits the aesthetics more when I was in that really hot sunny place to not wear a jacket. It just kind of like looks more fitting and looks more appropriate, even though we know it doesn't change things. So now it's raining. It will look more appropriate if people are wearing jackets. And Ignis and Prompto can probably benefit from the HP more than the strength anyway, because they're little weaklings. They're squishy support characters and they keep getting killed. Gladio's fine, Gladio's great. But I think, like, they do need... Why is Warsword there? Like, Gladio and Prompto do need the extra HP. Because it's not like the AI is that great and contributes that much to damage dealing anyway. I just want them to stay alive. So, now that everyone is jacketed up again, let's talk to Dave for the fourth time. Prompto, what are you asking? What's that? What is what's that? What's Dave? What's Dave's dog? Like, you've seen dogs before. You've seen
Howdy,
Dave
boys.
Before.
Y'all happen to stumble across another tag out there in the field. Do me a favor and bring it my way.
Before looking at the details for that, I want to...
Let's find somewhere dry!
Let's.
I want to get the one from Sonia as well. Are you a tipster? No, you're a shop.
Hey there.
Is there a tipster here? Okay, I'm gonna buy some more repair kits.
Thanks.
In case I find more NPCs. Car stuff I wanna buy just while I'm here. Because I don't want to have to come back for it later. Fishing stuff. Okay.
See you next time.
So you were not a tipster. Oh. Maybe Sonya's the tipster then. Oh no. Well, it'll still be good to go in here anyway. This is exactly the same! And I know it's the same franchise. It's the Crow's Nest Diner. I was like, most stores in the same chain don't look exactly the same on the inside. They have different layout or something, but this
Welcome
is exactly the same
Nest.
Diner.
What's on your minds?
Quest destinations. Oh. Oh, okay, so he knew where the dog tag was. I see.
So, what do you want to know?
Is that it, or do I need to talk to you again? No, that's fine. So there are hunts.
So, you think you're pretty tough, huh?
It would be weird going back to level 12 hunts when I'm used to level 17, 18, not even 20. But I'm not going to bother with that
we'll
for the time
around.
Being. Just gathering as many objectives as I can. Yes. Obviously, there is a quest waiting for me here. Wait, that's Fairy Godmother Lady, isn't it? It's Fairy Godmother.
Huh?
Are you Sonya? If you are Sonya, why can't we just talk to you directly? Why do we have to go stand at this very particular patch of floor? Where there is obviously something important that we should interact with here in order to trigger the quest. Like, obviously, this patch of floor. This game is really weird. They've made some weird choices that I don't fully understand.
Well, if it isn't Sonya.
Like, huh. Talking to
somebody
people.
You know?
Spoke with her just the once, back at Hammerhead.
No, we've seen her twice.
You were chatting someone up.
She's real knowledgeable about wildlife. Could teach us a thing or two. Go on and introduce yourself.
We've seen her already. Fairy Godmother.
What is it now? If you don't mind, I'm rather busy at the moment. Oh, it's you boys. Wait, who are you again? And what do you need now?
Nothing.
You're saying you distracted me for nothing? This won't do. Won't do at all. Precious seconds down the drain. How am I to make up for them? Of course. You boys can help me.
Okay.
That's the spirit. I was just thinking I could use a few extra hands. For catching frogs, to be precise.
Wait, what? Frogs?
And if you're thinking any old frog will do, wrong. You're not getting off that easily. Only the red frog native to Ulster suits my needs. You'll need to get knee and elbow deep down at the slough. With that, I'll get back to my work. Remember, it's red frogs, and make sure they're fresh.
So this is going to be like FF9 with the frog catching minigame. We're going to have to run around and pounce on things. Like, I'm not Queener. I didn't think I was Queener anyway. So that's all the way down there. That's all the way over there. Now, can I just ignore all of this entirely? And just go back to later. This is too soon for me. It's too soon. I wasn't ready to move on. I'll have a brief look
that
around the town.
Overwhelming.
Let's hope it'll be edifying as well.
Another
How did you manage to talk to her?
Oh, you know me.
Ready or not? Oh, love the lighting.
Sorry, Gladio, if I interrupted you. You can never quite tell when you're done speaking or not. So, what's also quite disappointing is that though there is different weather in the game, it doesn't seem to change in any one place. Now, all the time that we were in Lyda, it was always really sunny, like bright skies. It didn't seem to be like random or on a cycle or something was changing there, that it would change from good weather to bad weather to cloudy weather to stormy weather or whatever. It seems that that was just permanently good weather, and it seems like this might be permanently bad weather. Oh, I hope that's not the case. I hope it will actually cycle, since it's something that they showed off in the Platinum demo. Like, they were showing off that they did have these different weather effects, and you could like press on a button to change between the states. It didn't seem like it was something that needed to be fixed. It seemed like they could transition between the different types of weather quite fluidly. So I hope we get to see more of that in the game itself. And maybe that's expecting too much. It's kind of hard to tell when this game was in development for so long and there was so much hype for it. It's hard to tell what is going to be expecting too much of the game or what's going to be a reasonable expectation based on what they have shown us in the demo and based on like features that they have presented.
We're here.
It is quite comforting to see other people about.
This probably isn't going to be available until the side quest. Nope. We'll have to do the side quest with Prompto first, and then that'll become available. Maybe I should have done that first then, anyway. I've gotten by just running around on foot this long. Won't hurt to get by a little bit longer. And there's still tons of things that I've missed. Like, I've tried to go to all of the various places and points of interest on the map. I've tried to be thorough.
Welcome to Golden Key.
I've tried to be thorough, but there's still so much that I've missed, and I've been watching my fiance play as well, and he just by taking slightly different routes or doing things in a slightly different order or going a slightly different way, he finds all of these things that I haven't found, and likewise, I find things that he doesn't find. So there's plenty of things that I have missed, and I wouldn't mind going back on foot just to cover more ground and to find all of these extra things. But for the time being, you know.
There he is, the prince himself. You look good.
You know.
Hey, sorry about the whole boat thing. I pulled some strings, but ain't nothing anyone could do after that fiasco at the Citadel.
Forget it.
Done and done. Man, I tell you, this reporter gig alone ain't enough to pay the bills. So I've been working real hard on the side.
Wow.
Yep. So, you busy?
Why?
Cause I need your help. You fetch me some more, I trade you one of my pieces. Just like last time. Bada bing, bada boom.
Stop moving your arm while you speak, Dino. This is just like Tidus in FF10 all over again. Just recycling the same animation three or four times in a row.
Well-being is less important than his livelihood.
And we fell for it.
Guy's got no dignity, but he's full of deceit.
Meh, I don't mind helping him. So long as it doesn't involve any danger.
So where actually is this place? Okay, that's up here. Okay. It'll be a matter of taking the car then. What was that? What? Why did my stamina just instantly replenish? This glowed green and then suddenly my stamina was completely back. Is there something special about, like, if you happen to... Okay. I may have stumbled across a secret mechanic. If I'm holding square to sprint and then I let go right at the last second, it seems to just instantly replenish his stamina. I will need to do some more testing of that. But that is very interesting if true. Oh yeah, manual. I can drive manually, so I might as well. Luckily, it just navigates out of the car park automatically. I really don't know why I couldn't just do this from the start. Like, even having selected that I would leave it to Ignis, I don't know why there wasn't a way to go back on that decision and change your mind. I'd be like, actually, you know, even if I wanted Ignis to drive the first time. Because it really doesn't make that much difference. Like, if you're just going to be stuck to this track anyway. I guess I am holding down R2 now when I didn't have to before. I have more choices about turns on the road, and also just being able to start and stop whenever. But it really doesn't make that much of a difference whether it's Noctis or Ignis driving. Because even with Ignis, you could kind of control it to some degree in that you could force him to stop if you wanted to press X to hop out, or you could make him U-turn. So I just don't understand why they just locked down on the option like that. I don't understand why he keeps jumping instead of examining things. Or why it's so difficult to lock on and then off of enemies. I was going to talk about Type 0, wasn't I, at one point? Because that's also all about the Empire, well, pretty much all of the Final Fantasy games are about an empire, or the empire. The majority of them involve empires, and they're always evil, and they're always technologically superior and more advanced. And they have that power, but they abuse that power. But Type Zero especially, it really focuses on this war between four different nations. Okay, should have turned to the right there. Well, that's what U-turns are for. Whee! And, yeah, Type Zero has a lot of mechs. And, like, militarizing those mechs and weaponizing them. And just all of these, like, full-out wars between the nations. And Six was also about wars. Like, the Resistance members versus the Empire with their mechs. But Type Zero focuses much more on the military aspects rather than, I don't know what you would call it.
Everybody out.
Aye, aye.
It focuses much more on each individual battle rather than
Should be a nice change of pace.
Using war as a way to frame the story. Okay. My bad. And there's lots of epic boss fights.
It's close.
Epic boss fights you against the pilots of the various mechs. And all of them seem to be random warp strike.
Blockade!
Watch out!
Stay down!
Don't be late. Remember,
we're on the same page.
Just because I have the Sword of the Wise equipped, it will automatically initiate battles by using warp strikes. And it's really confusing sometimes because it's difficult to predict. And great, it's night already. It's not good. There's lots of fights with these like military captains and generals who are piloting mechs, and they're really, really patriotic, and they really believe in the Empire, and they also have similar sayings when they...
All that's left is to find the stone.
When they inevitably explode... Oh goodness, it's going to be another one of these such missions, isn't it? I take it Gladio just means that there's more medtech troopers on the way. So they'll arrive when they arrive. Which I guess is now.
Mouth closed!
You've come a long way, Prompto!
Gotcha!
Let it be done.
You got me.
You're mine.
Oh, sorry about that.
This one's just for you.
Farewell.
Here goes.
What time is it?
Whenever their mechs inevitably exploded. Well, what is it now?
Okay.
It would all say things like, "For the Empire."
They won't know what hit them.
My hero.
As that guy did earlier.
You rang?
Outstanding, Noct.
Yep.
I don't know why I bother trying to talk in this game. It's so difficult. So difficult just to finish a sentence. And to finish saying, are you kidding me? Oh, for God's sake. I don't think it would be any better if it wasn't nice. I was harpooned again.
Say your prayers.
Okay, Stucky. I'm fine.
Stay there.
Hey! Gladio got him.
What did you expect?
Gotta love it.
Nope. Yeah.
Gladio, do it! Nice work, Gladio!
Farewell.
I never knew what hit him!
Now that these guys have appeared and they have started spawning, they just come so frequently. Even if it was daytime, they would still be coming this frequently. That is a night specific.
Time to give him the goods.
Oh. Okay. That went easier than expected.
Knocked. Overhead.
No, not again. No, I leave the car. So I think I'm going to need to rethink this strategy. I'm going to need to return to town, rest somewhere. There's almost time for it to be the end of the episode anyway. So I think I'll get to the car and call an end to it there. And I wasn't paying attention to my stamina again, even though that was the whole point of keeping the bar. And the car's here now anyway. So yes. Call an end to the episode there. No. No fighting. No. I'll just talk overweight mode.
No.
Oh, that's even worse. Okay, I'll just get outside the ring. So quite a lot happened this episode. We completed chapter 2. We went to a new area very briefly, only to then just turn right around and head straight back. But next time, I'll pick up right from where we left off, go down to Dino, and also rest an inn somewhere so it doesn't have to be night anymore. Oh no, something's coming. Okay, better go. See you next time.
Magitech engine.